morning and welcome to Beginning the Day with God on Saturday the 20th of August. Our opening piece of music was Keith and Kristin Getty's By Faith. And now let us pray. Blessed are you, Creator of all. To you be praise and glory forever. As your dawn renews the face of the earth, bringing light and life to all creation, may we rejoice in this day you have made. As we wake refreshed from the depths of sleep, open our eyes to behold your presence and strengthen our hands to do your will, that the world may rejoice and give you praise. Blessed be God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Blessed be God forever. We come now to our reading. And we continue to look through the book of Acts today, chapter 3. One day, Peter and John were going up to the temple at the hour of prayer, at 3 o'clock in the afternoon. And a man, lame from birth, was being carried in. People would lay him daily at the gate of the temple called the Beautiful Gate, so that he could ask for alms from those entering the temple. When he saw Peter and John about to go into the temple, he asked them for alms. Peter looked intently at him, as did John, and said, "Look at us." And he fixed his attention on them, expecting to receive something from them. But Peter said, "I have no silver or gold, but what I have I give you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, stand up and walk." And he took him by the right hand and raised him up. And immediately his feet and ankles were made strong. Jumping up, he stood and began to walk, and he entered the temple with them, walking and leaping and praising God. All the people saw him walking and praising God, and they recognized him as the one who used to sit and ask for alms at the Beautiful Gate of the temple. And they were filled with wonder and amazement at what had happened to him. Thanks be to God. Our reflection today focuses on the last line that we have just heard, and they recognized him. Our reflection asks, or did they? In this story, the disability was in the society who could not perceive the man's needs and gifts as he was. The miracle of recognition is what was needed for him to be a human among humans. Here we need to understand the focus being on the apostles giving him what they thought he needed. So yet again, he was ignored and unrecognized. For people who live with disabilities, they find themselves often ostracized by miracle stories such as these, which on the surface can seem to point to physical and mental normalcy as the ideal. Sometimes we even hear from church leaders that the majority's version of our embodied selves is God's ideal too. In the time of this passage, holding to a conventional physicality was the doorway into the social, economic, and religious dimensions of life. In that society, the miracle enabled access to what should always have been his: love, connection, equality, and justice. But we can do better as we learn to encounter each other as God does. The apostles and the worshippers might not have recognized the man, but the man could no doubt have recognized them. Maybe in his delight, he still recognized he was a prop to the apostles' popularity and an anomaly to the crowd. Let us acknowledge the ones so easily othered. Maybe they can help us to begin to recognize ourselves. Amen. And now let us pray together the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Lord our God, as with all creation, we offer you the life of this new day. Give us grace to love and serve you to the praise of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Good and gracious God, come. Come and abide with us. Come and guide us. Come and protect us. This day and forevermore. Amen. Thank you.